Hi, in this video, we'll learn how to calculate the number of days until today dynamically. To calculate the number of days until today, we can take the difference between the date field and today's date in order to get us the number of days between them, which is the number of days until today. And we're going to use a formula called today to get us the today's date dynamically, so then this number will be automatically updated as we progress and move on to the new day. So here's an example to illustrate what I mean. Say for example, we have the order date on 1st January and today's date is 5th January. So you will get a result of 4 days if you are using our calculation. Say now we move on to the new day, which is 6th of January. Now the result would be 5 days. So this means that the calculation will always be updated automatically by using this method. But where can we apply this kind of calculations? Let's take an example of e-commerce business. Say we want to know how long since the customers has last ordered from us. So let's say if the customer last ordered from us is 3 months ago, then we might want to send them some promos so then they come back to us to do business with us. With that in mind, let's move on to Looker Studio so I can show you how to create that calculator field. We can use date time D formula to calculate the duration between two dates or date time values. So first of all, we're going to go to dataset 2 because this is the dataset that we're going to use for this example. Then we're going to click add the field to create a new calculator field. And I'm going to name it as days until today. In the formula, key in the date time div function. As we have learned in the previous chapter, we always start with the later date, which is today, because today will always be progressing and it will always be bigger than the order date, which has already happened in the past. So key in today, and then we can key in the order paid date and follow by day because we want the difference to be calculated in days. You can see for today, we didn't specify any time zone here because we are assuming the order paid date is in UTC time zone, which is the default of the today function. So if you know that this order paid is in another time zone, for example, if it's in GMT plus 8, then you have to indicate the time zone so that the calculation can be done correctly. For this example, we're going to assume this is a UTC time zone, and so the today formula doesn't require any time zone specification. And we can click save and finish. Now let's add a table chart to check the values of the calculation. So we're going to have order paid date here, number of days until today. We can put it either in dimension or in matrix, doesn't matter. So now for 17 January, it's calculated as 187. We can actually do a simple search on Google to validate the number of days we calculated here, whether it's correct. So you can see that for January 17, 2023, it will return us 187 days. So that is correct. That's all for today. If you have any questions, feel free to post it in our community page and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you so much and I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.